सक्सेसिव डिफरेंशिएशन एंड लेबनीज थ्योरम। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी सक्सेसिव डिफरेंशिएशन एंड लेबनीज थ्योरम। ओके, सो व्हाट इज सक्सेसिव डिफरेंशिएशन? सो फर्स्ट वी विल स्टडी ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशिएशन। ओके, सो एज वी नो इफ वाई इज ए फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स, सो डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ वाई विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स इज कॉल्ड ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इज नोटेड वाई डी वाई वाई डी एक्स। ओके, सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव ऑफ ए फंक्शन एफ एक्स लिमिट एस टेंस टू जीरो एफ ऑफ एक्स प्लस एच माइनस एफ एक्स अपॉन एच। ओके, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव। इफ वी डिफ्रेंशिएट अगेन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड सेकंड डेरिवेटिव एंड डिनोटेड बाय डी टू वाई वाई डी एक्स टू। सिमिलरली इफ वी डिफ्रेंशिएट दिस फंक्शन अगेन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड डी थ्री वाई वाई डी एक्स थ्री। ओके, नाउ इफ वी डिफ्रेंशिएट अगेन एंड अगेन एन टाइम्स, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एन एस डेरिवेटिव मीन्स डी एन वाई अपॉन डी एक्स एन। ओके, सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ दिस टाइप डिफ्रेंशिएशन इज कॉल्ड सक्सेसिव डिफ्रेंशिएशन। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन? सो डेफिनेशन ऑफ सक्सेसिव डिफ्रेंशिएशन इज लेट y is a function of x, then differentiation of y with respect to x again and again is called successive differentiation. Okay, so this is the definition of successive differentiation. Now some notations of this differentiation means if y is a function of x, so first derivative is denoted by dy by dx, second derivative is denoted by d2y y dx2, third derivative d3y y dx3, and nth derivative is denoted by dny y dxn. Some authors also denoted by these symbols means y dash or y double dash or this thing y triple dash up to yn. Okay, in other form we can write y1 d2y upon dx2 y2 d3y upon dx3 y3 up to yn. In terms of capital D means capital D is denoted by d over dx, so in place of dy by dx we will write capital dy, so this is first derivative, d2y means second derivative, d3y means third derivative up to dny means nth derivative. So the use of nth derivative in future questions and when we will solve problems on Leibniz theorem, so this is very useful. Okay, so first we know y is a function of x, so this is first derivative dy by dx, so we continue this process d2y upon dx2 d3y upon dx3 up to so on, so then this process is called successive differentiation means differentiation of y again and again, so this process is successive differentiation. This is very easy because we have differentiation of functions. Because suppose this is a any function, means this is y, this is x and this is y. So this is function y is equal to fx. Here x is called independent variable and y is called dependent variable. Here it is clear, if we change x into y, means x is a function of y, then same thing. Here we differentiate x with respect to y. So here we will write dx over dy. So this is differentiation of x with respect to y. So this is first derivative, and similarly d2xy d by 2, this is second derivative. So this depends on question, how we differentiate. So if y is a function of x, then we calculate dy by dx, d2y upon dx2, up to so on. If x is a function of y, then same fashion we shall obtain this type of function. Okay, so this is the differentiation. Very easy, some examples, means if y is a function of x, then calculate the derivative of y with respect to x. So it is very easy, like dy by dx. Dy by dx means differentiation of y with respect to x. So here dy by dx is equal to 18x square plus 10x plus 3, because differentiation of constant is 0. This is first derivative. Similarly, d2y by dx2. Okay, so this is 36x plus 10. Okay, d2y by dx3, then d3y by dx3. So this is 36, because this is constant, and d4y by dx4 is equal to 0. So here this function is 3 power of x, means x cube. So differentiation of y maximum we can differentiate 3 times, because after differentiation of dy upon dx3 we get constant. Okay, so now we will remember all the formulas of differentiation. Okay, so it is very easy to explain how we differentiate. Okay, so this is a very simple example, means y is equal to a cos mx plus b sin mx, then show that d2y upon dx2 plus m square y equal to 0. Okay, so proof is very easy. First we see y is equal to a cos mx plus b sin mx. Okay, so here a, b and m are constants. So first we see a, m and b are constants. So we need the formula of sin x and cos x, means d dx sin x is equal to cos x, and d dx dy by dx cos x is equal to minus sin x. Okay, only we need the differentiation of sin x and cos x. So first we differentiate y with respect to x. So this is first derivative, dy by dx. Okay, so this is cos mx minus sin mx, so minus m sin mx plus b is constant, sin mx, so cos mx into m, so m cos mx. Again differentiating with respect to x, so d2y by dx2 equal to, this a and m are constant, so minus a m constant, differentiation of sin mx, so cos mx, and then m, so a m square, plus b m cos mx means sin mx into m, so m square minus 1 sin mx. Okay, so here m square is common, so minus common, a cos mx plus b sin mx. So this is the second derivative of given function, means d2y upon dx2 is equal to minus m square a cos mx plus b sin mx. Actually, this is the second derivative, but we need show this type, means we need answer in terms of y. So here given in our question, y is equal to cos a cos mx plus b sin mx. So putting the value of y here, so this will be d2y upon dx2 is equal to minus m square y. In other words, d2y y dx2 plus m square y is equal to 0. Okay, so this is a simple problem on differentiation. So you can solve so many problems on differentiation, means you differentiate one times, two times, and up to so on. So this is very easy example on successive differentiation. Now, nth derivatives of some important functions, means if x to the power n, even function is x to the power n, so dn xn means nth derivative of x to the power n is equal to this thing. And similarly, so many functions we have given here. So I am going to explain one by one, means how we differentiate. So first is y is equal to x to the power n. So first we differentiate with respect to x, means y1 is nothing but dy, means first derivative. So this is n, x to the power n minus 1. Similarly, we differentiate again. So this is called d2y. D2y nothing but d2y by dx2. So this is n, n minus 1, x to the power n minus 2. If we differentiate again, means d3y. So n, n minus 1, n minus 2, x to the power n minus 3. So we see here very carefully, this is first derivative. So here n means n to the power 1. D2y upon dx2 means n and n minus 1. Means if we differentiate two times, so there are two term of constant, n, n minus 1. Here 2, so here 1. D3y upon dx3 means d3y, so n, n minus 1, n minus 2. Here product, in product 3 terms, okay? So here 3, so here 2. 1 less than of derivative. And power is same. Here 2, so here 2. So in general, we differentiate n times, okay? So we can write very easily here n, n minus 1, n minus 2, how many terms here in product? N, because if d2, so here 2, d3, 1, 2, 3, dn, so here n, n, n minus 1, n minus 2, so nth term, what will be nth term? So please see here, here 3, so here 2, here 2, so here 1, so last term, nth term is, if here n, so here n minus 1. So n minus 1, okay? And x to the power n minus n. Because if we differentiate 2 times, so here 2, 3 times, so here 3, so n times, so here n. Now, this is n minus 1, n minus 2. So this is n minus n plus 1, okay? N minus 1, 0. X to the power 0, 1. So n minus 1, n minus 2, up to n cancel, so here 1. So here from first to last numbers are decreases, n minus 1, n minus 2, up to 1. This is last, means before 1 here 2 and here 3. So we can write also, this is in factorial form by definition of factorial n, okay? So this is the differentiation of x to the power n, n times. So you will remember this result we will use on questions of successive differentiation. Okay. Next, this is important formula, y is equal to 1 upon ax plus b. So how we calculate nth derivative? So y1 means first derivative. So here this can be written as ax plus b to the power minus 1, because we know differentiation of x to the power n equal to n x to the power n minus 1. Okay, so here n is minus 1, so by the formula n is minus 1, ax plus b to the power n minus 1 means minus 2, and then differentiation of this function means a into x, so differentiation of x is equal to 1, so into a. Okay, similarly, so here minus 1 into a is constant, so ax plus b to the power minus 2. So here we see y1 means if differentiate 1 times, so here minus 2. Again differentiating, so we get y2, these are constant, so minus 1 into a, this is minus 2, ax plus b to the power minus 3 into a. Okay, so now here minus 1 and minus 2 into a to the power 2, ax plus b to the power minus 3. So if we continue this process, so we get yn. So how we calculate? So please see here, y2 means number of terms in product 2, minus 1, minus 2. If we get, we calculate y1, so minus 1, y2, minus 1, minus 2. So first we see this term. So yn minus 1, minus 2 into minus n. So in product, there are n numbers. Now, if we calculate y1, so a to the power 1, y2, a to the power 2, so yn, a to the power n. Here, y1 ax plus b to the power minus 2 means if here 1, so here minus 2. If we differentiate 2 times, so minus 3. Any 1 increase, okay? So ax plus b to the power minus n plus 1. So this can be written as minus 1, minus 2, minus n, a to the power n upon ax plus b to the power n plus 1. Okay, so since in each term contain minus, so we take minus common, so minus how many times? 1, 2, n, so minus 1 to the power n, because these are in multiple. So here 1, 2, 3 up to n, okay, a to the power n upon ax plus b to the power n plus 1. So by definition of factorial, this is factorial n, so minus 1 to the power n factorial n a to the power n upon ax plus b to the power n plus 1. Okay, so this is again new formula, means dn 1 upon ax plus b is equal to this thing. Now similar formula means dn log ax plus b. So you can obtain very easily, because if we take y is equal to log ax plus b, okay, so first derivative y1 is equal to 1 upon ax plus b into a. Okay, so as we calculated here dn 1 upon ax plus b, so here y1 is equal to a upon ax plus b. Okay, so how many differentiation now need? N minus 1. So we get yn. So if we put in this formula, in place of n is n minus 1. So this is very easy. So yn is equal to a, and so what is the value of this thing is, so minus 1 to the power n minus 1 factorial n minus 1 e to the power n minus 1 upon ax plus b to the power n minus 1. So one cancel, so here a to the power 1 cancel, so this is the formula yn is equal to minus 1 to the power n minus 1 factorial n minus 1 e to the power n upon ax plus b to the power n. Okay, so this is very easy. Now nth derivative of trigonometric functions. So first is sin ax plus b. So nth derivative of sin ax plus b is equal to a to the power n sin ax plus b plus n pi by 2. So how we can calculate this value? So we take, suppose y is equal to sin ax plus b. Okay, so y1 is nothing but first derivative of this function. So as we know, differentiation of sin x is equal to cos x, so this is equal to cos ax plus b into differentiation of this thing, so a. Now I want to explain this function in terms of sin. So as we know, sin 90 plus theta is equal to cos theta. Okay, so this is sin 90 and pi by 2 plus ax plus b, okay, into a, so a is here, so this is y1. Now similarly, y2 means again differentiating this thing, so a is constant, sin theta means differentiation of sin x is equal to cos x, again cos pi by 2 plus ax plus b into this thing, so 0 plus a into m1 plus 0 means this is a. So this whole thing can be written as a square cos pi by 2 plus ax plus b. This again in terms of cos, I want to convert in sin. So again, by the formula sin 90 plus theta is equal to cos theta, so a square sin pi by 2 plus pi by 2 plus ax plus b. So this is a square sin 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b. So this is y2. So in general, here y1 is equal to a sin 1 to pi by 2, y2 is equal to a square sin 2 into pi by 2. So in general, yn is equal to a to the power n sin n pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Or this can be written as yn is equal to an sin ax plus b plus n pi by 2. Okay, so this is same thing. Again, I am going to explain for cos. So let us suppose y is equal to cos ax plus b. So y1, what is y1? We have differentiation of cos x is minus sin x, so this is minus sin ax plus b into a. Also we have in terms of cos, so cos pi by 2 plus theta is equal to minus sin theta, so minus sin theta can be written as in terms of cos, so a into cos pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Okay, so this is y1. Again differentiating with respect to x, so we get y2 equal to, again differentiation of cos x is minus sin x, so here minus a sin pi by 2 plus ax plus b into a, so here a square. So again we apply the same formula, means in terms of cos, so this is a square cos pi by 2 plus pi by 2, it means 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b, okay. So this is y2. So it is very easy, like we have explained sin x, so y1 is equal to this thing, y2 is equal to this thing. So in general, we calculate yn is equal to a to the power n cos n pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Okay, so these two formulas are very important to calculate some problems on trigonometric functions. Okay, so you remember all the formulas of nth derivative, like we explained before, six formula, and now two formula is sin ax and cos ax. Okay, some examples on Leibniz theorem. Okay, so find nth derivatives of following functions. So first is, you see dn u v, what is u and what is v, e to the power ax. So as we know, the formula is, if you take first function u and second v, so first function in the derivative, okay, v as it is. So you remember, when you have x, x square, x cube, so always you take this is second, because we calculate very easily by putting second function x power n, okay, because the formula of e power x is valid for nth derivative, but this is valid for only two times, okay, because here x square, if here x cube, then differentiation is valid for three times, okay. So now we will take here dn e to the power ax into x square. So first, what is the formula? Formula is dn u v as it is, okay. So dn e to the power ax, this thing as it is, plus n c1 dn minus 1 e to the power ax, one differentiation of x square one times, so 2x, plus n c2 dn minus 2 e ax, again so 2. Now next term is 0, because differentiation of 2 is 2 is 0, because 2 is constant, okay. So now we have dn e to the power ax is equal to a to the power n e to the power ax into x square, plus n c1 is n factorial n upon factorial, because we have n cr is equal to factorial n upon factorial r, factorial n minus r. So n c1 factorial n upon factorial n minus 1, factorial 1. So n and minus 1 cancel, so n c1 is equal to n. Now dn minus 1, so a to the power n minus 1 e to the power ax into 2x, plus n c2 means factorial n upon factorial 2 n minus 2, so n upon factorial 2 n minus 2, okay. And this is a to the power n minus 2 e to the power ax into 2. So now this is a to the power n e to the power ax x square, plus 2 n ax, 2 n x a to the power n minus 1 e to the power ax, plus here 2 to cancel, here if we expand factorial, so n minus 1, so n minus 1, 2 to cancel, a to the power n minus 2 e to the power ax. So this is the answer. So you remember, when you have product of two function, term x square, x cube, this contain power of x, so you will take always this is second function, because this is very easy to calculate, okay. So now I am going to solve second function, means x square sin 3x